So when you have GERD, oftentimes you may need to have some diagnostic testing done. The way that I have folks think about diagnostic testing is to evaluate, number one, the anatomy. So is there something abnormal about the way things are put together within you that may put you at risk for developing GERD? And so sometimes that includes what's called a swallow test or an esophagram. It's where you will drink some contrast and they'll take pictures with x-rays to see how things go down, looking for any signs of hiatal hernias or problems with stuff going through the esophagus into the stomach. Then you can move up to more invasive imaging procedures such as CT or CAT scans, they're called, which can evaluate the anatomy. And then also endoscopy procedures. So where a doctor will take and run a camera down your throat and take a look, you can see things like hiatal hernias. You can also see something called esophagitis, which can be where you've got irritation from reflux. You can also see more advanced problems in association with reflux, like Barrett's esophagus. So those are the tests to look at anatomy. Then there's also a test to look at function. How does the swallowing tube, the esophagus, and the stomach work? So again, the swallow test can sometimes give you some information about how that's working, but there's also something called manometry, which is a catheter that's often placed, and patients take sips of water and we watch how strong their esophagus can move things through. You may undergo something called EndoFLIP, which is during oftentimes the endoscopy procedure. Patients can have a balloon that has a pressure catheter, and we can watch how the esophagus works, but also how things relax at the lower aspect of the esophagus. And then the other test that oftentimes we have patients undergo is a pH probe test, something called a Bravo pH test. And so that's an actual measurement of how severe your acid reflux is. The probe is typically placed in the esophagus above the stomach, so we know if it is seeing acid exposure, you truly are having reflux. And that test is often done over a course of a couple days, and that can give some objective values, actual numbers of how severe your reflux is.